Hi, welcome back to Guitar Discoveries. Today, we are going to explore the sonic wonders of the baritone electric guitar. These used to be kind of uncommon, but they were used to really strategic effect on certain recordings. More recently, they've become more popular and more readily available, hence the price has been going down. So, is it affordable for you? We're going to explore that. And why would you want one? What is it? Stick around. So a baritone is very similar to a standard tuned guitar. All the chords that you've learned and the hand positions you've learned are going to work. The difference is that it's tuned down a fourth. So you go from what would normally be an E chord played down here at the first fret is actually a B chord. It sounds like this. Very deep, very full, very low. Now that explains why for some of these metal guitarists who love to tune things really low and get a very growly tone, a lot of them favor baritones. Now, what makes a baritone able to play so low? The answer is a much longer scale length. This, in fact, is a 29 3/4 scale length. Now, that's compared to, you know, something usually 4 or 5 inches shorter for a standard guitar. But that longer scale length means you can put on thicker strings and play much lower. It's much closer to a bass, in a sense, like an electric bass, where you've got a very long scale length as well. The cool thing about this is a DANELECTRO, a 56 reissue. And 56 was, I believe, the first year, or certainly one of the first years, that DANELECTRO introduced the baritone. They were the first company to put out an electric baritone guitar. So, how cool is this that now you can get a DANELECTRO? It actually has a remarkably high quality of build. I was surprised when I got this that it actually holds up to my Jerry Jones, which is like a very premium DANELECTRO. This one plays pretty similarly and has a lot of the same kind of quality to it. Now, beautiful thing about this, you can now get these DANELECTRO baritone reissues for somewhere between $400 and $500. Now, if you're smart like I was, watch for sales, special opportunities. I got this for well under $400, and that's part of why I did it. I don't think I would have spent a lot of money on a baritone, but to spend some money, get a good deal on one, and have it in your arsenal, fantastic. So when I think about the reasons I fell in love with the sound of a baritone guitar, even before I knew what that sound was coming from, I can go back to, let's say, the Beach Boys, Dance, Dance, Dance. You know, that's a great riff, and it totally depends on the baritone to pull it off. You can actually see the original version of this guitar on the cover of $1 Million Worth of Twang by Duane Eddy. He was really the guy who was the early adopter, right? He was pulling out a baritone and getting that twang right from the beginning of time. So you can listen to the song Commotion for a second. So Duane Eddy had a huge influence on a lot of the guitarists of his day. And so the baritone became very popular among guitarists who were pickers like that in Nashville. It would often be used for sort of the tic-tac sound that would mirror the bass. It would actually double the bass an octave higher with that sort of tic-tac sound. So that was part of it. It caught on very quickly in Nashville and in country music. Probably because of that, it started getting used in themes to spaghetti westerns and in the soundtracks. So, you know, this kind of thing. Smart session players back in the 50s and 60s would often pull out a baritone guitar to create something very unique. Glen Campbell really liked a baritone, and you can hear it very prominently on Wichita Lineman and also a great solo on Galveston. Now, if you barrel forward into the modern era, you got all kinds of metal players who have played baritones because of how deep it is, just that it can get really low, nasty tones, and it holds tuning very low, unlike a standard guitar, where if you tuned a standard guitar down to a low B, your strings are just flapping and they're not playing in tune. So it's really key for that. There have been some other great and more recent uses of a baritone, one of my personal favorites, Dave Matthews' The Space Between.
You cannot quit me so quickly. There's no hope in you for me.
I just love that tone. I mean, it's so massive. I love the Arctic Monkeys. Alex Turner pulled out a baritone for If You Were There, Beware. All right, so I'm hoping that's enough to convince you that a baritone can be something really, really cool to have in your collection. So to give you an idea of one of the ways that I might use a baritone, I love single note lines played on baritone. It really highlights the incredible depth of the instrument, and it often occupies a space in a mix that you don't expect a solo to be coming from. You know, most guitar solos are screaming and high. Well, what about twisting everybody's ears a little bit and having a guitar solo that's nice and low? So in one of my previous guitar discoveries, I was showing how to layer guitars using Nashville tuning, and I used Free Fallin' as an example. I thought I'd pull that up and show you how you could add a baritone as a solo instrument in this kind of sound. So check this out. Nothing fancy, right? But that just lays in the pocket in a really cool way, and it's not what your ear would necessarily expect. Okay, so the Danelectro 56 reissue is available now in the low 400s in most cases, and you can find some that have different finishes. There's red, there's sort of a cool turquoisey color, there's sort of these metallic finishes. I was able to, by getting the black model, I was able to actually get it for less money than if I'd been paying for some of the fancier finishes. But that's really all up to you. I wanted it for my recording rig so that I can add this incredible texture whenever I want to. And if I want to do something really low, I can do it. So there's your guitar discovery for the day. The wonders of the baritone electric guitar, in this case, a Danelectro 56 reissue. I hope you'll check one out. And just have some fun with it, because it's a blast, man. Really, really fun. Please subscribe. I want to share more tips, tricks, cool axes and things with you. And this is the only way I know how to do it. So I hope to see you on a future edition of Guitar Discoveries. Thanks. See you soon.